You're listening to the Full Court Press with your host, Drew Duncan. Don't you dare touch that dial. Welcome back to the Full Court Press. I am your host, Drew Duncan. We're live on 99.5 ESPN Radio, Emporia's home for sports. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is all at Drew Duncan 83. Additionally, you can call in at 620-343-6143. That's 620-343-6143. As I made mention earlier, we got a huge show to get to today. Kyler Murray. May be foregoing his final season in OU to go and play baseball in the minors. We got that on tap. We've got Nashville as being the front runner for the NFL draft, though I think it should be in Kansas City. We'll talk about why. We've got bulletproof cup holders to discuss on the show, guys. That's going to be awesome. Kyle Lowe's retires in dramatic fashion. We've got that on tap as well. 620-343-6143 is the number, and you may chime in at any time. Dwayne Casey gets fired, and I'm going to tell you the real simple answer. It's not because of them getting swept in the NBA playoffs by the Cleveland Cavaliers. It's not because he's not a good coach. It's not because the Toronto Raptors have not flourished under Dwayne Casey. It is for one reason and one reason only, and that there have been multiple reports that have circulated through verification that LeBron James was telling guys during the games where the Raptors, where their players should be lining up. Nah, man, you're supposed to go over here, bro. Hey, you were supposed to be over there guarding this guy. Hey, you were supposed to be over here doing this. Now, look, I'm not going to take anything away from LeBron James, because that tells me that LeBron is studying and putting in the film work and listening to the coach. That's exactly what that tells me. It tells me that Tyronn Lue should be getting a lot more credit than he really gets for the preparation of his athletes. But you know what that also tells me? That tells me that Coach Dwayne Casey had absolutely no other game plan for the Cleveland Cavaliers. He had nothing in his back pocket that he had saved for anything else. Nothing up his sleeve, no alternate game plan, nothing. And at this stage in the game, one of the things that I talked about going into this series was, if I was Toronto, I would have something set that LeBron James and the Cleveland Cavaliers have yet to see. Those were my exact words. And the example that I gave is the one that I'm giving now, and that is when the Atlanta Falcons played against the Denver Broncos when Denver had Peyton Manning, they implemented a very specific defense strictly for Peyton Manning. And what they did was is they lined up all over the field to make it look like they didn't know where they were or what they were doing. Manning had no way of identifying what kind of defense they were preparing to attack with. And thus, it created utter chaos for the Denver Broncos offense. Manning turned the ball over several times in the first three quarters of that game, and Denver got dominated. Yeah, if you go look at the final numbers, it'll look like Manning had a great game, but a lot of it was garbage yardage in the fourth quarter. That's why I always say the numbers don't lie, but they don't always tell the entire story either. It's exactly what happened in that game. And Denver came back a little bit, but by then, Atlanta had already softened and peeled back and was basically like whatever with the game. Why didn't Dwayne Casey implement something in this series in preparation for LeBron James and the Cleveland Cavaliers? Look, the Raptors played tough. There were a couple of close games in this series, but a lot of these, quote, comebacks from the Toronto Raptors were in situations that were basically too little, too late. They were too little, too late, and that's all there is to it. The fact of the matter is this. That's why Dwayne Casey is gone. You have to be able to strictly game plan for certain teams and certain players and certain individuals in certain situations. There was nothing new that was offered by the Toronto Raptors. When you've got guys from the other team saying, you're supposed to be over here, that tells me that one team did their due diligence and another team decided whatever we're doing works and there's no reason to deviate from that game plan. I don't understand that mentality 100%. That was one of the things I talked about with the Philadelphia 76ers, being a one-trick pony. Eventually, it can get the better of you. And when you're a one-trick pony or you've only got a few set plays that you run and you've got guys saying, ah, this is where you're supposed to be at, that's why you get blown out in a game four. That's why you get annihilated. That's why Dwayne Casey's gone. I mean, and if those other reasons are included, fine. But I'm telling you right now, with that coming out of the woodwork, you can probably bet your bottom dollar that that was the straw that broke the camel's back. If the Raptors had any inkling of keeping him at all, that was it. As soon as you hear that and as soon as that gets verified, bro, you're gone. And you're, you know, we love what you did here. We appreciate your services. Me personally, I don't think Dwayne Casey should have been fired, but I can guarantee you that that's probably what did it right there. You have to really kind of take a step back every now and again, you know, and just see things from a bigger picture. You know, I said yesterday, and I've said several times already on this program and throughout my career as a sports journalist, and that is, I don't believe you give a coach less than four, but you never give him more than seven. And one of the things I talked about was it was Dwayne Casey's seventh year to get him past the second round. It was his seventh year. And it was right at that moment that the Raptors had a decision to make. As far as where is he going to go? Look, it's really difficult right now. I mean, these windows and gaps are closing. Charlotte is in need of a coach after they decided to fire James Burgo. So Charlotte needs somebody. But here's the deal. There's a lot of other teams that need somebody, but a lot of them have already gotten done with the interview process, i.e. the New York Knicks. The Grizzlies, they just signed J.B. Bickerstaff. So that's a closed deal now. Then, of course, you got the Milwaukee Bucks. But if rumor has it is correct, it looks like Becky Hammon could be the first ever lady head coach in the NBA. Especially when you've got Pau Gasol of the San Antonio Spurs writing in letters to the Players Tribune that are specifically about encouraging Milwaukee and other teams to hire Becky Hammon, saying, look, dude, she's not going to be a good coach, or there's the possibility. He said, quote, she can coach the NBA, period. So that's going to be a really big hurdle that Dwayne Casey is going to have to get over. Not that he's in competition with a woman, but that he's in competition with somebody who a guy like Pau Gasol, who's an NBA champion, clearly believes is qualified for the position. Milwaukee was at the same point. Milwaukee was kind of at that breaking level. How do we get to the next level? You have to understand that while a lot of people, including myself, believe that the NBA is primarily a players' league, I still believe in coaching. I really do. And we've talked about it before about guys getting out coached. I think we saw that specifically with Boston and the Sixers series. I think we saw that when I talked about how Boston, if they were going to win, they should take the strength of the Philadelphia 76ers and use it against them and turn it into a weakness. And that's exactly what they did. That's what happened. That's what the Falcons did with Peyton Manning. They took his strength of reading the defense and making adjustments at the line of scrimmage and used it against him with that specific gameplay. I mean, that goes exactly right back around to Dwayne Casey and his, I don't want to say inability, but for whatever reason, he just didn't implement anything that Cleveland wasn't ready for. You know, Billy Donovan for right now is safe in Oklahoma City. So where does he go? I mean, right now it looks like Charlotte is going to be the only open window for Dwayne Casey. Whether or not he'll fit, you know, who really knows? I mean, that's ultimately, I don't like that. Is he a good fit system-wise? What are the guys used to, et cetera, et cetera? If you're a good coach and you're a player who's willing to learn anything at all, anybody can fit to me in any system. Yeah, I understand that there are certain players who you can't really ask to really be outside of themselves. We know that. But I think that one of the things that we talked about yesterday was with Kyle Lowry, how he said that for 7 years he was allowed to be the kind of player that he is. And so we know that Casey is a player's guy. But at some point, you can't just be a player's guy. You have to be able to step in, assert yourself as a coach, and say, look, I know you want to do this, but we are going to train you to be able to be outside of what even you think that you are capable of. I'm going to make you do things that you never thought that you could do before. To me, that's really all there is to it. Do I think that Becky Hammon would be a great fit in Milwaukee? I mean, you've already got guys over there like Giannis who are incredible athletes. And don't think that for one moment that her being there wouldn't add to the recruitment when you've got ball players like Pau Gasol saying, I'm co-signing to her, she can coach. When you have backing from other players, especially NBA champions, then that tells me if I bring this person in, then they'll be able to go out and get people because they'll want to coach under her because she's got a good reputation among players. Now, obviously, so does Dwayne Casey. But do they see that Dwayne Casey is the best option? He could end up in Charlotte. Who knows? Now, I will say this. I think Casey's going to end up somewhere. Maybe not this coming season, but he will end up somewhere. Whether or not he should go to the collegiate ranks, I haven't heard anybody talk about it, but we see this from time to time, right, where guys go from the NBA to college and back. I don't know. I mean, that's going to be on him as to whether or not he wants to take a step back. Look, there's 351 teams in Division I college basketball. There's always a coaching need. There's always a slot that's open somewhere. It's whether or not he wants to take it. It's whether or not he wants to, quote, take a step back, though I don't necessarily view it that way. It's about patience. Maybe he takes a year off. Who knows? Look, I'm not in the mind of Dwayne Casey, and I'm not into telling people what they should do with their careers. I don't believe in that. What I'm telling you is these are the facts. He's no longer with Toronto. A lot of the doors have already closed, and it looks like Charlotte may be in the NBA his only true window of opportunity. The Suns just signed an assistant coach out of Utah. That's another one that closed. I mean, this is really bad timing for Dwayne Casey in terms of getting let go. It is really bad timing. Because any opportunity that he would have had before, he may not get. With Milwaukee being out already, they were able to go and find somebody. Truth of the matter is this. The Milwaukee job is still open, and so is Charlotte, but it looks like Becky Hammon may be next in line. And if you've seen her on the sideline, she asserts herself very well. She played the game herself at the collegiate level, played at the highest level in collegiate level. She's been in coaching for a while. There's nothing wrong with going after her and saying, let's give her a chance. Let's see what she can come up with here in Milwaukee. Let's see if she can take our team to the next level. With any coach, everything is all about balance. And I think that Dwayne Casey didn't find that extra step. Maybe Becky can find that extra step. And you got to remember, too, that she's learned under Pops. I mean, these are all things that they have to consider. There's so much here to consider right now. And I got to tell you, I don't know that Dwayne Casey ends up with the Bucks. I think Charlotte's his best window. For the time being, it's all speculation. We don't really know. Bottom line is this. He's no longer in Toronto, and I'm 99% sure the straw that broke the camel's back was LeBron James was telling other teammates on Toronto, hey, no, bro, you were supposed to be there. You didn't do your job. You made mine a lot easier. Appreciate that. You got a game plan for you have to specifically game plan for guys like LeBron James. This is all there is to it. This is the Full Court Press. I am your host, Drew Duncan. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is all at Drew Duncan 83. You can always call in at 620-343-6143. That's 620-343-6143. We've got a lot more to get to. Coming up on the other side of this break, we've got Kyler Murray and the chance that he has to potentially forego next year with the Oklahoma Sooners and play in the minor leagues. We're going to tell you why it could be so enticing for him. Coming up right after this, this is the Full Court Press on 99.5 ESPN Radio, Emporia's home for sports. I am your host, Drew Duncan. Don't you dare touch that dial.